Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. In today's show, I'm giving out grades of the 10 biggest offseason additions by the Raiders on defense. I already did offense, and I'm kicking off defense with Erik Harris, and I'm giving this one a B grade. Erik Harris is a player that I really like. Now, they signed a two-year, $5 million deal with Harris. He played better down the stretch of the season for the Raiders, and I'll say this, 2018 was a great year for Harris. He grew up a ton as a player and finally got his chance to show what he's got. Now, he's a leader for this team in the locker room and on the field, and I think he's going to be able to coach up a bunch of younger players. So last season, Erik Harris, 49 tackles, 7 pass breakups, 2 interceptions, sure, 0 forced fumbles, but hey, Erik Harris had a solid year. That's why they brought him back for 2 years, and that's why I'm giving it a B grade. Let's move this show right along with Lamarcus Joyner. Spoiler alert, this is my highest grade that I would give out on the show. It's an A+. Signed him to a 4-year, $42 million deal, $21.3 million guaranteed. Joseph and Abram, they're expected to play safety, and one of the reasons why I love Lamarcus Joyner, why this is an A+ grade, is because Joyner can play nickel, he can play safety, he can play all over the field, and this is literally going to allow Jon Gruden, and this is going to allow Paul Guenther to be able to have a very fun and creative defense. And when I think about what Joyner has really done for this Rams defense, I mean, the Rams, since 2018 and 2017, have been one of the better teams in the NFL, and heck, Joyner helped the Rams get to the Super Bowl, where sure, they lost to the Patriots, but still, Joyner, when you have the ability to be able to do so many different things with one player, it opens up so many different aspects of the football game. Now, with Joyner, he's going to play nickel cornerback. So if you watch my Raiders rumors segment, Joyner right now is listed as the nickelback because Carl Joseph Abram, they're expected to start week one at strong safety and at free safety. And when I think about this defensive back depth chart for the Raiders, Gerrion Conley, Daryl Worley, Carl Joseph, Johnathan Abram, Lamarcus Joyner. There is a lot of talent in this secondary, and I'm excited to see what's going to happen, because when you play in such a tough division, like the AFC West, you're going up against a Patrick Mahomes, you're going up against Phillip Rivers, you better have a lot of talent on that defense. So I'm going to ask everybody watching the show right now on Facebook, on YouTube, doesn't matter where, I want you to comment below. Who is the Raiders' best defensive player? Okay, is that one of the players that I mentioned? Who is the Raiders' best defensive player? If you want to know what I think, hit me up on that IG or Twitter game. All right, let's get these grades going. Johnathan Hankins, I'm giving this one a B+ grade. He signed a 2-year, $8.5 million deal with $5.25 million guaranteed. He's going to start for the Raiders at defensive tackle next to Maurice Hurst. Maurice Hurst entering his second year, and the reason why I like Johnathan Hankins a lot, he's really going to be able to help teach Mohurst, I think, really how to live up to your upside, because I think Hankins is one of those players who, he's a solid run stopper. And sure, 2018, he had 36 tackles, 4 tackles for loss, and 2 QB hits. But his best time was with the Colts, and Hankins was always one of these players who I think never quite lived up to the hype, because I don't necessarily know if the want to be a dominant player is there. But at the end of the day, he's going to help this defensive line, because let's be real, the Raiders' biggest need this offseason was improving their defensive line. So I mentioned Mohurst, and I mentioned Johnathan Hankins. So which of these defensive tackles for the Oakland Raiders is going to have more tackles for a loss in 2019? So if you think it's going to be Mohurst, I want you to type M-O for Mo, or to type J for Johnathan Hankins. And if you want my answer, well, sit tight, okay? Sit tight, because if you're watching on YouTube, there's going to be a quick commercial break, and then I'm going to give you my answer. Now, if you've made it through that commercial, much appreciated, so thank you to you if you're watching on YouTube. So more tackles for loss in 2019. I'm typing Mo. I think Mohurst, I know we're talking about Hankins giving it the B+, but Mohurst, I think, is going to be the better player in the defensive interior for the Raiders, and I'm going more tackles for loss. I'm going with Mohurst. All right, let's get this one going now with one of my lower grades. Sorry, Josh Morrow. I think you're a talented player. Now remember, okay, A is like absolutely incredible. B is good. C is an average move. I think by the Raiders signing Mauro to a 1-year, $1.4 million deal, it is an average move. A former UDFA great, played with the Giants last season. He, at the end of the day, He adds depth to the Raiders' biggest team need, which was defensive end. It's a reason why they're hanging up 13 in their locker room, because they only had 13 sacks. Now, sure, you go back and you look at the last 4 years, the dude only has 3 sacks. But when I think about the entire Raiders' defensive ends and I think about the Raiders' defensive line, the more talent and more bodies you can add, it's at least a C grade for me. Now, let's go to another A grade here. Vontaze Burfict, and some of you might be surprised I'm giving an A-, but all the reports right now out of camp are that Vontaze is showing up, and he's showing up on the field, but what he's really doing is he's putting younger players underneath his wing, and he's helping them get involved in this Paul Guenther defense. Remember, Burfict has been with the Bengals, and he played with Paul Guenther for such a long time. Heck, his best year, realistically, came with Paul Guenther back in 2016. And when I think about all these awesome things that the Raiders have done this offseason, at first, I didn't really like the Vontaze Burfict move. But now I hear the reports that Vontaze is really helping out a lot of these younger players, and he's helping out the defense learn what Paul Guenther wants to see on defense, which is why I'm giving it an A- grade. But this show's not about me. You guys know that. It's about y'all, and I love interacting with the nation. So, grade the Vontaze Burfict signing. A, B, C, D, or F. I want to know from everybody watching on YouTube. If you're watching on Facebook, grade the Vontaze Burfict signing. Again, I'm giving it an A-. Now, let's do a quick little recap here of the first 5 players that I went over here for the Raiders offseason additions on defense. Erik Harris, I'm giving this one a B grade. Lamarcus Joyner is an A plus for me. Johnathan Hankins is a B plus. Josh Mauro is a C. And then Vontaze Burfict is an A minus. Let's go to Brandon Marshall, not the wide receiver, but the linebacker. Signed a 1-year, $1.2 million deal with the Oakland Raiders. Best year was in 2017 when he racked up 106 tackles. I think he's a solid veteran who knows how to play in the AFC West, and the Raiders really needed help at the linebacking position. So you're going to go out, you're going to get a Brandon Marshall who, sure, like, you're going to look at some stats here by Marshall. Like the Broncos, y'all might hate the Broncos, but the Broncos have one of the better linebacking cores in the entire NFL. And if, you know, history repeats itself here, 2015, over 100 tackles, 2016, down year, 2017, 106 tackles, 2018, down year. Hey, man, I'm hoping history repeats itself, 2019, over 100 tackles for Brandon Marshall. So I'm going to ask you guys this question here. I gave A- grade for Vontaze, but who's going to have more tackles in 2019? I want you to type BM for Marshall, or I want you to type VB for Vontaze Burfict. And if you want to know what I think, hang tight. I'm going to show you another quick little ad here on YouTube. So sit tight, because when it gets done, I'll give you my answer. Did you make it? Yeah, I hope you did. So more tackles in 2019, BM for Marshall or VB for Burfict. I'm typing my BM for Brandon Marshall. I know I gave Vontaze Burfict a higher grade, but I think what Vontaze is going to be able to do is bigger off the field and in the locker room, helping out some of these younger players, kind of be like a coach on the sidelines when he's not playing in the game. But more tackles, give me Brandon Marshall. Now, let's go to Nevin Lawson, next player I'm talking about here. I'm giving this one a C-plus grade. Signed a 1-year, $3.05 million deal. I think he's actually a pretty solid cornerback, and he's played in 63 games, so he's going to bring some experience and 54 starts. Now, he spent those first 5 years with the Lions. Now, why am I giving this only a C-plus grade? Because it's the 1-year, $3.05 million. I think it's actually a little bit overpriced considering what the Raiders did in the draft. Now, Nevin's going to be a solid player, but paying $3.05 million to somebody who I think maybe only playing half the snaps for the Raiders, a little bit overpriced for me. Now, sure, 2018, 53 tackles, okay? 2017, 43 tackles. Fun little fact, I don't know if it's very fun, but he has 0 interceptions his entire career. Nevin, how about this, my man? If you get an interception, all I want you to do is tweet at me and be like, Mitch, did it for you. Can you do that? Do you watch the show? We'll find out. How many times, guys, did you watch my live show? How about, we'll ask this question. Do you watch my live show every Tuesday at 6 p.m. Eastern time? Because I don't think some of y'all did. So how many times did I change my outfit on last week's live show? Because I was amazed that not really many people even noticed. So this one's coming in from Raider Nation shout out, No Name Taco. He said, why Mitch look like he finna start dropping bars about Compton? Well, No Name Taco, first off, get a picture, so this is what I found for you. And second, I changed my outfit multiple times on my live show. That's why. that's why I'm looking like I'm trying to finna start dropping bars about Compton. Oregon Poop, one of my favorite commenters here. Renz, I love you, bro, but that hat is ridiculous on you. I'm thinking a curve bill would fit your face 10 times better, bro. I can't wear flat bills either. Yeah, I'm actually not a hat guy whatsoever. I like my hair way too much, but for the sake of the show and for the sake of only One Nation, I wore some hats, so maybe I'll wear a curve hat on next show. All right, last one coming in from Michael Martinez. He just says, love the show. Michael, I love you as well, but can you please get a picture? Because apparently you're an Olympic, figure skater? I'm not quite sure. He's still like biting some gold. Michael, much appreciated to you. And if you guys want to get on the show, make sure you guys subscribe, youtube.com/RaiderSport. Or just click the button below where it says subscribe. It's really easy, and then I can feature you on the show. All right, let's keep these grades rolling. I'm giving out another A grade here for Daryl Worley. I was really excited to see the Raiders bring back Worley. They signed with that 1 year, $3.09 million deal. They're building around young talent. Now, Worley's going to be, I think, the cornerback to Gerrion Conley. You have an elite cornerback in Gerrion Conley, who I think is a top 10 corner in the NFL right now, and then you pair him with Daryl Worley. Why do I like bringing him back so much? Because he started 9 games for the Raiders last season and really started to play strong down the end of the down the stretch. Now you pair Worley, then you pair him with Lamarcus Joyner, and now you have your two top safeties in Carl Joseph and Johnathan Abram, and I'm excited to see what Worley's going to be able to do and what this defense is going to be able to do ultimately. I mean, you're talking about depth. What did Jon Gruden say? Jon Gruden wanted to add more depth at the cornerback position, and he did that by bringing back Worley and drafting a whole bunch of talented players. Speaking of drafting a whole bunch of talented players, the Raiders drafted Trayvon Mullen in the 2019 NFL Draft, and I want to know from everybody watching right now, who's going to have more snaps in 2019? I want you to type W for Worley or type M for Mullen. Now, somebody attacked me on Twitter the other day and said, Mitch, you're dumb for having Worley over Mullen. Well, how about this? If you're watching, prove it to me. Who's going to have more snaps in 2019? W for Worley or M for Mullen? Let's go to Jordan Richards, the next player on my list. I'm going to give this one a C-plus grade. Now, he signed a 1 year, $895K deal. Not so bad, right? Now, he's entering his fifth year in the NFL, and he was on the Falcons in 2018. Now, he was drafted by the Patriots, and one of the things that I like about when somebody's drafted by the Patriots, you can learn under a very smart scheme. Also, he has experience playing in big-time games. Sure, he might not have played in many of them, but he was at least a part of it. Now, last year was by far his best year. By far his best year, and really why he got on the field is because the Falcons suffered so many injuries. So, the fact that he was able to start 12 games, right now he's third on our depth chart at the safety position. When you can add a player who played in 12 games last year and he's the third player on your depth chart, I'm giving it a C grade, but at the end, it's a player who's at least going to be able to add experience to our depth chart. All right, last player on my list here who I'm grading is Benson Mayowa. He signed a 1 year, $1.7 million deal with $750K guaranteed, a former UDFA, and he played with the Arizona Cardinals last season. I don't know if you guys remember this, but the Cardinals actually used to be one of the better defenses in the NFL, especially after getting after the cornerback. So Benson Mayowa might not be a name that y'all have heard about, which is why, for me, I'm giving it a B-minus grade because it also fills a huge need for the Raiders. This guy is long, he's lanky, and he's kind of able to get after the quarterback, but he's also a monster at getting tackles for a loss. So 11, he had 11 tackles for a loss last season. 38 tackles, but look at the tackles for a loss. He's staying consistent those last 3 years, and when I'm trying to get after the quarterback, when you're trying to put pressure in that backfield, Benson Mayowa is going to be a solid defensive end. I don't think he's going to start. I really don't. I think it's going to be Cleveland Furrow, and I think it's going to be Arden Key on the sides, but being able to rotate a player like Benson Mayowa, who has experience, giving it a B minus grade. Now, Benson Mayowa had only 4 sacks last year, and the Raiders as a team had only 13. So who's going to lead the Raiders in sacks in 2019? I've already given you my answer. I think it's going to be Arden Key. But from what I've heard from Raider Nation, it's a little bit of a mix of Arden Key, some Mo Hurst, some Cleveland Furrow sprinkled in there. But I want to know from everybody watching on YouTube and on Facebook, who will lead the Raiders in sacks in 2019? Now, let's do a quick little recap here of my 10 grades that I just did on today's show. Erik Harris, I'm giving it a B. Lamarcus Joyner is an A+. Johnathan Hankins is a B+. Mauro is a C. Vontaze Burfict is an A-. Brandon Marshall, you're a B+. Nevin Lawson is a C+. Daryl Worley is an A. Jordan Richards, a C+. And Benson Mayowa is a B+. minus. Raider Nation, y'all are an A plus in my book. Make sure you guys subscribe, youtube.com/Raidersport. Make sure you always interact with me on IG and on Twitter at MitchellRenz365. And if you made it this far in the video, thank you very much. And all you got to do, click subscribe. Also, I got a video set up for you coming up. Raider Nation, what's going on? Is this the number one Raiders channel on YouTube? For Chucky Heads, believe it, baby. And if you haven't already, subscribe right here. I'm giving you Chucky Heads news, rumors, Raider Nation rumors. And look at this. I'm making your life easier. Check out my next video. Thanks for watching, and go Raiders.